Alright, you're up.
Aaron Burr was a highly intellectual young man whose father was the co-founder of Princeton University. And at the age of 13, he attended Princeton University and he graduated by the time he was 17. Both of his parents died at the age of 3, and he was admitted to the New York bar in 1782. He was married to a lady named Theo Deja, and she was a widow with 5 children. She died around 15 years later, and they had a child named. So after that, he began to work with Thomas Jefferson, and that's all for him. Now I'm Aaron Burr. Thomas Jefferson was born in Shadwell, which is in Albert, Marley County, Virginia, and on April 13, 1743. His father was named Peter Jefferson, and he was a man that was known to everyone because he was an explorer and a map maker. His mother was named Jane Randolph, which was able to get him extensive private schooling. He attended William & Mary, where he worked with George Witt, who was probably the best law teacher at Virginia at the time. He was admitted into the bar in 1767, where he practiced until 1774. Which was because of the American Revolution, so they had to stop all the courts. He was married to Martha Skelton, where they lived happily and on his father's estate, where he had to stop living there because of his death, where he eventually just decided to build Monticello. Later on in his life, he served as a county lieutenant and Albert Marley, and he was elected to the House of Burgesses when he was 25, and those skills demonstrated that he was an effective committeeman and skillful draftsman.
Okay, well, I'm Thomas Jefferson. I am here today to run for President of the United States in the election of 1800. I'm representing the Democratic Republican Party, and Aaron Burr will be my Vice President. I'd like to tell you that I can be a great help to this country as president. I believe in the common man, not just the rich man. Everything should not be focused on the rich man. By focusing solely on the rich man, half of our country is forgotten. Not every man can afford huge tariffs on goods or a tax on whiskey. By doing this, you're taking from the poor and giving to the rich. It seems to be that the objective of my opponent and Federalist John Adams. Because John Adams is favoring the rich, he's putting an even larger gap in the American society. Is this what you want? Rich are rich and poor are poor. John Adams also sided with Great Britain in their feud with France. And didn't Britain try to rule over us not too many years ago? I side with France and aren't the French and their army not the reason we are free and having this election today? Do you want a president who sides with the enemy, who sides with the people who try to imprison our country and keep our freedom? Is that what you really want? I know I don't. And why, may I ask, do you want a central government to have all the power so our country can turn to a monarchy? No, a republic drives the power to the people, and the people are the states, so I give the states the power. Gentlemen, I ask you, do you want to give all your power and freedoms away? If so, John Adams is your man. But if you want to keep your freedom, as I do, vote for me, Thomas Jefferson, as the next president of the United States.